Christy. Are you ready to review how to prepare the 53401 for patient use?
Yes, I am.
Okay, great. Let's get started. First, let's review where you can find more training.
That would be very helpful.
So since we won't cover everything today, I'll show you where you can get more information on Medtronic Academy. Have you used Medtronic Academy for training or technical support in the past?
Yeah, I've used Medtronic Academy to find training materials and resources.
Great. Here is a learning plan that will cover all your training needs for the 53401. In addition, you can search for individual training materials here.
Great, that will be very useful for our new nurses.
There's also a support page, and of course, you can also contact your Medtronic representative.
Thank you. I'll be sure to check out Medtronic Academy and share with my team.
Okay, now let's discuss how to prepare the device for patient use. Before we leave Medtronic Academy, I wanted to show you the tip card, reviewing everything needed to prepare the device. You can view and download here, on Medtronic Academy, or have your representative order you a copy.
Excellent. That will be a useful resource to keep with the 53401.
Okay, now let's talk about getting ready to use the device. There are some checks you'll need to do before you use the device. So first, make sure the device is clean and disinfected according to your organization's policies.
Is more information on cleaning available?
Yeah. You can refer to the manual or go to Medtronic Academy for a video on cleaning. Next is the service check to make sure the device and cables are free of any defects. You'll need to examine the device to ensure the functionality of the controls and the battery drawer closes properly by hearing that click.
Okay, everything is working here.
Next, you'll also want to make sure there are no cracks in the case or other defects. After that, you'll need to check the cables. So visually inspect the cables before using to ensure there's no deterioration, brittleness, cracking, thinning, or bare spots.
Okay, checking the cables for signs of wear before each use will continue being a priority for us. How long can these cables be used?
Oh, great question, Christy. The disposable cables may only be used one time. The reusable cables may be cleaned and reused. So be sure to check on your institution's policy on sterilizing and reusing cables. Okay, so now that we've inspected the device and cables, we need to put in a new set of batteries.
Okay, I recall these steps from our earlier discussion. It takes size LR6 or AA batteries. We should only use alkaline batteries and not use lithium or rechargeable ones.
Yes, great job. And do you remember how to install them?
Yes, press these side buttons simultaneously to release the battery drawer. The battery drawer shows the direction for battery polarity. Once the new batteries are placed, the battery indicator will show all bars.
Great job, Christy. Okay, so now let's talk about connecting the cables to the device. Do you know why there are two different colors for these cables?
Isn't the blue one for the atrium and the white one for the ventricle?
Correct. For more information on cables, you can use the cable compatibility guide, and we'll practice connecting the leads and cables to the device. While we don't have a patient today, there are some key points to remember when connecting the device to the patient. For the patient's safety, make sure the device will not capture when connecting the patient cable.
So the output should be turned down so there is no capture.
Yes. Now let's practice connecting the cables. First, make sure the device is turned off.
Okay.
Then plug the cable into the cable socket.
I heard it click.
Yes, you want to make sure you hear the cable click into place. You'll also want to pull gently on the cable to make sure there's a good connection.
Like this?
Yep, exactly. Next, you'll connect the lead to the cable. So for bipolar leads, match the polarity of the lead end to the cable receptacle.
Okay.
So when first connecting the device, you would proceed with a sensing test followed by a pacing threshold test. Once the device is ready to use, you'll want to place it near the patient so that it can be observed by the medical staff. One option is to use the IV pole hanger. If placing near the patient, be sure to close the protective cover. Another option is to use the attachment panel of the disposable pouch.
Okay, let me see this.
So this goes right in here.
Okay.
Like that.
Great.
Okay, so now you're ready to use the 53401 temporary pacemaker.
Thank you.